Everybody, welcome to my next edition of Old Homes. You've seen the Clark House and Stone Mansion. Now I'm going to show you my mom's house in Annandale, Virginia. And this is where I grew up when I was a little kid. I was a little Cub Scout here. Went to an elementary school just up the street, and we're going to take a little walk up there in a second. But I thought I'd show you her house. What I was doing was living up in this room up here in the corner. When I came back a second time, I was living in this screen and porch area right there. I believe this lantern was in Japan with us. I could be wrong. And right now my mom is being very cool, letting me keep my motorcycles right here. This is all while we are moving to Georgia. When I was little, I'd come out of my bedroom right there onto the roof, come over here, climb down this tree, and that's how I'd sneak out late at night. I was a bad kid even at a little age, trying cigarettes, sneaking out of the house at night. I'm talking like I was like a little Cub Scout, maybe like third grade. So when I was staying with my mom in the early 90s for the few months before going to Hawaii, I wanted to have my own space a little bit, not be upstairs or downstairs in my sister's bedroom because she was at college. So I opted to live on her porch, and it had a separate door than the front door of the house. And on this porch, it was not heated or cooled. And it was very, very, very cold during the time period that I was in here. So much so that I had to sleep under an electric blanket and a ski cap on my head and thick socks, long underwear, all that stuff. But anyway, this is the porch. And this is the entrance that leads to the rest of my mom's house. I would just slide that open and close to go into the house. But this was it. And my mom has it nicely decorated with, I guess, Micronesian, Polynesian, Hawaiian type stuff. Things that we've gathered over the years, like shell collections, brooms. But it was just a screened in porch. The windows weren't the best. And what I did was over here, I put my stereo system and CDs. Over on this side, I built a loft bed that was level with the top of the bricks there, threw a mattress up on top, threw a dresser underneath it. And that was my bed up here at this level. Had a sofa right here. Hung some pictures up, hung some posters up, hung a surfboard up. Other things about this room was, I was a very messy person back then, so I did not take care of the room at all. It was pretty much trash. Had another sofa here, hung a tapestry right there for some privacy instead of those curtains. I did have some weird purple curtains from Purewood Imports that I put up on these windows. They were made out of paper. It was all the rage back in the late 80s. But this room was a very good little room because I could go in and out as I pleased through there. I could play my music here without bothering my mom or my grandmother who was living upstairs at the time. I could have people come and go through this door, and it was a good little spot, but it was meant to be temporary, and I moved out as fast as I could. If you were talking to my mom, she would tell you the story about the time I had a birthday party in here for one of my girlfriends, and it got a little crazy with food being thrown and cake flying up. It was all over the ceiling up there. She was not happy about that. And then I even had posters all up in there. I really moved into the space, even though it was supposed to be temporary. I'm not the world's best roommate, I guess. All right, we've just walked from my mom's house, kind of on the path I would take to come to school. This is my old little elementary school, and we're going to take a little tour around. I'll tell you a few crazy stories about it. Let's go. So the first thing up here is this large open field. And in this field, this is where I played soccer. And I remember getting the shin guards. And I remember hating soccer. I was not a fan of it. So I just kind of stood around out here Another time I was up here, this was the place where there was a pet show, and I brought two pets, Horatio the dachshund and Charlie, a little frog that I had in a terrarium. And Horatio the dachshund won best dressed and best trained, and Charlie the little frog won smallest pet. And that was right here. There's pictures that we'll try and find. Also on this field, it was really cool. My dad came back from a military trip once to Australia, and he brought back a boomerang. And so that's the first time throwing a boomerang for me. And I remember my dad and I figuring out how to do it. And we actually got it to come back. I don't know if we actually ever caught it. It was kind of scary when it was coming right back at you, but I still have the boomerang. One time, walking to school, Horatio followed me, and he was outside the classroom windows causing a big stir. All the kids were looking out at him, and the teacher was like, there's a dog out there, and I'm like, that's my dog. So they made me take him back home. So right here was the classrooms where Horatio came and hung out, and we saw the dog outside there. And this play yard is where I had some memories. Many of them were good, some were bad. But gosh, I love this game right here, the Foursquare. Foursquare is so fun. And I remember one time I was out here, and this is where I got into my first fight. I had a fight with somebody. My first fight, third grade, right here. I was a little bit of a hellion, a little bit of a troublemaker. And I hate to say it, but even in my classroom, when the teacher wasn't there, I wrote something pretty bad on the chalkboard. And when the teacher saw it, was like, who wrote this? And I was like, that was me. Like, didn't even care. So, you know, I went straight to the principal's office for that one. But yeah, it was pretty bad. So bad, I'm not even going to say it. Anyway, now we're going to head back to the trail, going home. Okay, from the school, when school was let out, walk down a path and head through here to go home. And a funny story about this right here is this hillside. One time there was a lot of snow, and cars come in to drop off their kids, pick up kids right here in the circle, and then they leave. And we were just ambushing all the cars that were right here, snowballs. And the parents were getting so flustered, and they're slipping and sliding with their cars and getting mad at us. And we just thought it was the best thing, pelting their cars with snowballs. So I must have walked these steps 100 times or more. And a cool thing to show over here, I still remember this clear as day because it was just so traumatic for me. It was one of those snowy, icy days, and the sidewalks had sleet on them, little thin coating of snow, and I dropped my lunch money. My lunch money was in quarters, and clear as day, I can still remember this, but I dropped my, one of the quarters right here on the sidewalk, and I could not get it for the life of me out of the ice. I guess it was warm when it was in my hand or pocket, and it just kind of melted into the ice and instantly refroze. And I'm trying to chip at it and could not get it. And it stayed there. So I couldn't get my lunch that day because I didn't have one of my quarters. So traumatic. It was really so sad. One time out of this cul-de-sac, some teenager lived in that house and he had a little VW bug. And he could get that thing to move because he floored it. And he came out and he did a turn right here and he got it up on two wheels on the side. And we were all kids just kind of watching that going like, that was amazing. But we felt that was a little reckless, so we like squealed on them. Such an arcs, but there's my mom's house. And we're gonna go to the woods right now. Right all along, paralleling my mom's neighborhood, there's this track of woods and it's a really nice trail to run on, walk on, walk your dogs. It's pretty. Anyway, here's the creek bed right here. Let's see if I can show more of that. So that is the entrance to the storm drain, and all the runoff from the street just kind of goes down into the drains and into this creek right here. And this is where I learned how to fish, if you could call it that, for crayfish using just a little bit of bologna tied to a string. And those greedy little buggers would grab it, hang onto it. You could pull them right out from underneath the rocks. Okay, everybody. Well, I've got my wonderful, lovely mom sitting next to me. Hi, Mom. And you guys bought this house back in the 70s?
75, 1975.
75. And I was a little tight when I first was here. I was in the Cub Scouts and Weeblos, and I had my little friends up and down the street.
Right.
And I lived upstairs. I was telling everybody that my room was up here. Mm-hmm. But then that room became my grandma's room, Grandma Suda's room.
Right. Well, actually, it became like your dad's den at one time.
Okay.
And then Grandma Sue's room.
Yeah.
It went through three transitions.
And then, so when you guys lived here, we hosted Thanksgivings, obviously Christmases, Easter egg hunts. What was I like as a little kid here?
Oh, yeah, well, you were adorable always. But you were kind of rambunctious and did things that Mom didn't know you were doing, like going down in the sewer. And climbing out your window at night and going out into the neighborhood.
So
you were a little scamp.
A little scamp. See, I like that, like a little rascal. And then my sister was here, of course, but I didn't really interact with her much. She had the room adjoining mine. And so we had separate rooms as little kids. Then we moved away from here. We went to several different places. But you guys always kept this house along with another house in Norfolk.
Right.
When you guys were not here, who was here?
Renters, 10 years worth of renters who destroyed the house.
Oh,
when
I
came back, it was destroyed, let me tell you.
Well, then when you guys came back, it was without me because I stayed in Illinois to hang out with a girlfriend who didn't work out. You guys were here. And then when I was going to move out to Hawaii, you let me back into the house, kind of like as a 23 or 24-year-old. Scamp.
Right. Well, although at Great Lakes, so I did lock you out of the house when I remember, and then your girlfriend's mother called me and begged me to let you back in the house because you were camping out at their house.
Well, that's a story for another house, but for this house, I was here, and I did not get my room back because by then Grandma Sita was in the room upstairs, so I went out onto that porch area that you guys saw earlier, and it was a little bit cold, but it was fine, and I was only back here for about 4 months, I think, right?
I think so.
So then I moved out again. And then now I'm back again as a 55-year-old man. So thank you so much for letting me come back so many times.
You're the boomerang son.
I'm the boomerang son. And then this last time, how have I been as a... I love you too. How have I been as a roommate this time?
Oh, you're perfect. You are absolutely perfect.
No longer the little scamp, huh?
clean up after yourself. Just doing great.
Last time I was playing my music loud and I had parties in that room. And
you've matured.
I matured. So, but Mom, thank you for letting me stay with you yet again. Hopefully this is the last time.
Oh, okay. No, I might have to come stay with you.
You guys are welcome to come down and stay with us.
I can stay in the shed.
And your house has changed so many times over the years. I'm looking around and it's like never exactly the same because pictures come and pictures go. Mm-hmm. But is there anything you wanted to show me?
Fox one. Last night.
Is that the book that the Oscar movie was based off of? Oh, I need to look at that.
That's the ones that Scott sent me.
Okay.
That's the ones that Scott sent me.
Well, let's take a little quick tour. Okay. Oh, so first of all, here's the stairwell where, gosh, I learned to go up and down stairs. But then I would launch my Evel Knievel motorcycle off the top here and fly it all the way down to the bottom. Do you remember that?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes. Yeah.
Where did this grandfather clock come from? Is that Japan? Because it looks Asian.
Guam.
Okay.
25th wedding anniversary.
Oh. So the kitchen. Okay. And I made that, right?
That's right. When you were a little Cub Scout.
My first attempt at woodworks and crafts. I remember it was something I had to stain and then glue it all together.
Right. And I absolutely love it. Unfortunately, the picture is kind of deteriorating because it was a Polaroid. And they don't last that long.
No, they don't. So. My mom's got some cool pictures up on her refrigerator. I love that my dogs are represented. Of course, then the nephews and Sirius and my mom at Franconia. And then that one time we went up into space.
Mom's sister, Joanne.
Yep. Yeah, there you go.
This is the little breakfast nook where David has his Captain Crunch and quick chocolate milk drink.
Yep. And you got some cool things over here.
These are some cool things from Japan. And my sumo wrestling program.
Yep.
Which I loved and picked up in Japan.
Well, let's see how your outside's doing. Let's see, you've got...
Just had some tree work done.
Yeah.
Chopped off a lot of lower limbs.
Okay, so now we're on the second floor where the bedrooms are. I love this hallway, Mom, because you got some cool old pictures.
Debbie is a catcher, and then turn around, you with search and rescue, and your parade for President Bush.
Yep, the inaugural parade.
Right.
Japan.
Fox team.
And then, gosh, here we are, really little. See, I think that's the age when I lived here.
Yes.
At first, right there. Uh-huh. With Whit. Mm-hmm. But this room was my sister's.
Yeah, just the...
Oh my gosh, I want my Boy Scout badges. Well, speaking of old houses, that's one we lived in Hawaii. And you drew that, didn't you, Mom?
Yes, for Ambassador Hayden Williams.
So he has the original, or was given the original. That's a copy.
President Bush's name is on there. Hubert Humphrey.
President Bush, Hubert Humphrey.
Admiral Crow.
Yeah.
A lot of famous people from the 70s.
And then there's a big name right here. Up on the left, Gerald Ford. President.
And Hubert Humphrey. Carl Albert, those were big names back then. but those are their actual signatures that...
That's mine. That's a letter of appreciation when I was working with the Japanese Scouts.
Boy Scouts, right. Do this one with Chisuko.
Yeah, Chisuko. Well, cool. Let's go see my old room. That's Grandma Sita's. Well, this is my grandmother, Grandma Sita's room. It was my room first, but it's Grandma Sita's room.
And there's the window that you climbed out of.
This right? one. No, I climbed out this one right here. Oh, yeah, okay. I climbed out this
great.
One.
Great.
Yeah.
I always thought it was this window over here.
No, this one.
Okay.
And he's right here.
Grandma Sita was always in charge. Her little pillow.
And in my mom's room. Mom, this is a very blue room.
Yes, this is my neighbor across the street who does handicraft or handyman things for me said this is the prince's bedroom.
Well, when Whit and I were kids, we were scared of this painting because we felt her eyes were always looking at us.
Oh, that's right.
All right, well, thank you for the tour, Mom.
Oh, you're so welcome.
All right, thanks for having me stay here again. I appreciate it. Love you.
Oh,
bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
People talking, and they're saying that you're leaving. So unhappy with the way that you've been living. Oh, we always wish for money. Always wish for fame. We think we have the answers. Some things ain't ever gonna change. It doesn't matter who you are, it's all the same. What's in your heart will never change. Look in the mirror and see how you've been taken. Money. We
good evening. And you tell me you baked all day.
Happy birthday, David.
This is my mom, and Mom, tell me where you were 23 years ago today.
Huh? I wasn't feeling too good.
And this is my lovely grandmother, Grandma Sita.
David.
And there's Digger.
Hands so fast, David, don't be dizzy.
Time to emancipate. I guess it was a beating. On my plate, swallowed it down.